We started in January 2014 and we started with a very simple platform which has now grown significantly. Sheroos is a career platform for women and it's built as a community where women can come and find very diverse resources, very diverse opportunities, and they find a lot of support around things related to their career and their aspirations. So the monetization model is very simple. Women use Sheroos for free. They log into Sheroos and get themselves a Sheroos profile, they get a Sheroos dashboard, they can use any of the services for free. However, we monetize via companies. When companies use Sheroos to either build a program or to hire or to put their brand out there, that's how we make money. So Sheroos started as a very small idea because I saw huge gaps between the availability of large number of women who are really smart, who are educated, but are navigating their careers very differently. And then there are businesses, there are organizations who are always looking for smart people. So it started with that, but along the way we also realized that careers are forever. One needs to invest in a career every day. One also needs to keep up with their communities, get more support every day, and especially if one is custom fitting their own version of success and one is designing their own life, then it means all the more reason that women should be able to get help around this area. I think before Sheroos there was nothing that sort of catered to women and their aspirations, catered to women and their career choices, their their startup needs, their businesses, their talent. And I think that's the most exciting part. I think we've moved the needle from women being just a pink content category to a real professional network for women. So our user base comes from about 20,000 locations on the map. A lot of younger women in the workforce today, and I guess the workplaces will need to design themselves to cater to this large pool of talent that's coming in. Which means more family-friendly policies, safer workplaces, more progressive outlooks, breaking down of patriarchal attitudes, breaking down of stereotypes. I guess it's all part of that story that's playing out. Well, the single largest challenge for us was establishing the category. If you went out 4 years ago and you spoke to somebody and said, women and careers, it was a non-category. Everybody thought you're an NGO. You tell women how to make poppers, or you sort of must be teaching them how to weave or something, but there was nothing for the urban educated woman. And every time, even now when I go for meetings, my most commonly asked question is, are you an NGO, do you do this as CSR? And we run this as a consumer tech platform, and I guess that's a shift we managed to brought. But it was not easy because you still sort of come across a lot of invisible barriers around that, around creating the category. And let's face it, we're still a patriarchal country, so this is still early days even for a platform like ours. We've just raised a Series A round from Loomis Partners, HR Fund, and our existing investors, Quint Media. Well, stay persistent. Don't get into entrepreneurship for money. Get into it because you're passionate about it. The idea can't get out of your head. If you want to make money, go get a corporate job.
So start ignition, count to zero. I just wanna be a superhero.